I'm just a normal person with no video editing background who wanted to start making YouTube videos and maybe add semi-fancy effects. I don't really plan on making major motion pictures or commercials, so I was looking for a free, easy-to-learn video editing software. Luckily, I stumbled on Shotcut, a free open-source video editing program that has the potential to replicate similar effects that an Adobe Premiere or DaVinci Resolve can, but with a simpler, leaner interface. It just takes imagination. So let's learn together. So in this tutorial, I'll show you what I would do if I needed to copy-paste a filter or multiple sets of filters to more than one video clip. So right off the bat, I'm going to start out with two video clips that I took at the same day, and it's just me fishing on a dock. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this first video onto the timeline. And what I want to do is I just want to shorten it so that you can see just a quick snippet of that particular clip. I'm going to splice that and I'm going to remove all the extra. I'm then going to grab the second clip and put it on the same track within my timeline. Again, I'm going to trim it to about 10 seconds, splice it, and remove the extra. So what I'm going to do in this one is I'm just going to focus on this first clip. So I'm going to play that so you can see what it looks like. Again, just me fishing on a dock. And what I would usually do with my workflow is apply a filter to color grade it. And so I would usually start with white balance. And so let me choose white balance on the filter. I'm then going to select an area where I think should be a neutral color, and there I'll set my white balance there, and then I'm going to add filter color grading. I'm going to drop the shadows down. I'm going to raise the highlights, and then maybe drop the raise the midtones. And so let's leave it at that. And so this is what it looks like without the color grading, and that's with. And let me add another filter. Let's say to sharpen. And I'm just going to choose the default 50% and 50%. So that's what it looks like with the filter, and the second clip is what it looks like without a filter. And so typically, if you don't have that many video clips, all you need to do is go to the filter section here, you select this button, copy the filters, and then you go over to this next clip, and you select this button, paste all the filters, and what it essentially does is it copies all the filters and all the settings from the previous clip onto the next clip. And it works well, and it's easy. If you only have two, maybe up to five clips, you can just copy, paste, copy, paste, copy, paste. So what happens if you're editing multiples of, say, over 15 video clips or even more? You could argue you can still copy paste, but that's not an efficient way or efficient use of your time. And so what I would do is this thing that I basically just learned about 3 months ago. I didn't even know you could do it. So first and foremost, I'm going to remove all the filters from this particular clip. So let's remove it, and I'm just going to leave this set here. So at this point, only the first clip has all the filters applied, and the second clip doesn't have any filters whatsoever. Rather than applying it on the particular clip, especially when you have multiple clips. And, you know, just as an example, what I'll do is I'll go ahead and paste half a dozen clips. So now I have six clips in there. So theoretically, what I can do is I can select this button here and copy all the filters, then paste here, paste here, paste here, paste here, and paste here, right? But I found that a better way of doing it is copying this filter, once again, clicking that button right there, and then wiping the filter out of this particular clip, going into the track, which I didn't even know you can do. So now I've selected the track here, and then going into the filter interface again and pasting the filter there. And what happens is the filter gets applied to every single video within that track. So now if you go here, you can see it's at a set color. You go here, it's at the same color setting here, 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 and here. So if you have 25 video clips, rather than copy pasting 25 times, what you could do is you can just apply it into the track setting, and it then creates a universal setting for every single video within that track. What's good about it is if you did it the long way and you just copy pasted on every single one of the 25 clips, if you decided maybe I'm going to drop the color, I'm going to drop the intensity a little bit, you would have to make that change to every single one of those video clips. Whereas here, all you have to do is say, I'm going to change the color grading and I want to brighten it a little bit. The brightness adjustment that you just made essentially was applied to every single video within that track. Isn't that cool? And I literally just found out about this thing maybe 3 months ago. So prior to that, I was doing what everyone else was doing. I was copy-pasting on every single clip. And if I ever had to make a change, I'd have to do it to every single one. So this trick is perfect for someone like me, because when I go and record my fishing videos, I usually carry two cameras of two different brands. And what happens is because they're from two different camera makers, their color profiles are a little different. And so what I do is once I finish and I extract all the MP4 files, what I do is I put all the files from one camera on one track, and then I can apply a master filter to that particular track, and then I put all the files from the second camera on the second track, and then put all the camera filters and adjustments on that particular track. And that's how I match the color profiles through color grading between the two cameras. And so this hack, which I learned 3 months ago, definitely helped me out and definitely made my color grading process a lot faster. And hopefully it's going to help you as well. So let me know what you think of this filter tip. And if you have any other suggestions on what types of tutorials you want me to make, just go ahead and make a comment below and I'll go ahead and make it. And you haven't yet, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. It goes a long way to help me out and it encourages me to make a lot more of these tutorial videos. So please subscribe. And again, use the comment section below. Let me know what you think of this tutorial. And let me know if you have any other suggestions. So until next time.